All right, so the launch of Cyberpunk 2077 is just around the corner, and this is a game that has been really anticipated. Like, the original teaser trailer for this game came out in like 2013. It's been almost 8 years that people have been waiting for this game. Personally, I am very drawn to it for two reasons. Number one, I know the gameplay is gonna be good. Like, I like the developers, they make stuff like Witcher 3. I've always liked their games, but the big thing for me is the graphics. Like, this is some seriously next level stuff. Real-time ray traced open world environment in a city that is like super dense, there's so much stuff happening. It's my jam. Now, because this game has been rumored for so long, a lot of companies have been making like special edition, limited edition items for this, like themed to this game. And I was sent three of them, and I thought I would just kind of showcase them to you guys because these are cool. These are things that I think most people would never be able to have access to or be able to see. So I thought I'd spend a little bit of time making a video to just go through them. As I unboxed these things earlier, I realized that there's so many levels of detail that you can go into when it comes to making a special edition product. If you have some just light skin work, or it can go to the extreme where companies go ham and make like a full-blown experience when it comes to a limited edition product. So we have three things here. We have a Alienware laptop that is Cyberpunk themed. We have a Razer mouse that is also Cyberpunk themed. And we have a crazily customized phone, the OnePlus 8T, also Cyberpunk themed. Now, the common thing across all these devices is that they've been decked out in this iconic Cyberpunk yellow. So I'm gonna start off with the laptop first. This is their M17 R3. It's one of the best laptops they make. It's got an 8-core CPU with an RTX 2080 Super. This thing delivers frames. This has been done up with a custom skin on the top panel, the sides, as well as the keyboard deck. It's this bright yellow with a whole bunch of Cyberpunk themed kind of logos, and I want to use the word branding, but it's not really branding. It's more just like motifs from the game. Now, the other skinned panels on this laptop have some prints and logos as well, and it goes really well with the RGBs. Like, I think it looks good with the blue. You mix that yellow and blue, it looks just like their logo that they have. And on this top panel here, you'll see the phrase Night City a couple times. And this is it's the city that the game takes place in, right? It's this super dense environment. And I remember reading this thing from one of the developers saying that they were trying to create this environment that felt like a real city, like this real like post-apocalyptic city. And the only way to do that, the only way to make it believable, was just like pack it with life, to pack it with a ton of characters, a ton of interactable stuff that just made the player feel like they were actually immersed in a city. So that's the thing that I'm most stoked about. But it's a pretty cool limited edition device. I don't know exactly how much more expensive these are from their regular devices. I can't imagine it being like a crazy surcharge, but it's a pretty unique looking device. Now, this device did not come, at least from what I saw, in a special edition box or any kind of packaging. I don't see any special edition wallpapers either. It's just the skin on the device, but you get a really powerful limited edition Cyberpunk themed laptop. Now, the other two devices are more elaborate in how they achieved a special edition. So the first one we'll look at is this mouse. So this is the Razer Viper Ultimate, and I've reviewed this mouse before, but this one is special. Now, when I unboxed it, the first thing I noticed was they had put a bunch of detail and attention to the packaging itself, right? Unlike the laptop, this had a special package, and you can just see the whole Cyberpunk theme around it. They got the character, they got the cool fonts, and when you pop it open, it just jumps out at you, this crazy bright yellow mouse. And this is really cool to me. You got the yellow mouse and you get the yellow charging dock. Like, I feel like they could have included the regular black charging dock, people would have been okay. The yellow one is so much better, just, you know, the extra mile to make this special edition special, and I think it looks really cool. So this mouse is a yellow shell, like the top shell. The left and right mouse buttons are yellow and the side buttons are yellow. It's a very Cyberpunk themed mouse. It's a very lightweight mouse. If you're unfamiliar with it, it's, I think, 74 grams. It's a pretty lightweight pro-grade gaming mouse. The scroll wheel has this blue trim to it. In the pictures, I thought it was like a blue LED, but it isn't. It's just blue plastic, but there is that light-up snake logo on the back, and it just looks so awesome when it's going. It's a really nice mouse. The performance on this thing is great. It's obviously a high-end Razer mouse, and I think a lot of people like it, but this is how you do a Cyberpunk limited edition mouse. It is $10 more than their regular black or white versions, but if you're into Cyberpunk and you like yellow, This is well worth the $10, in my opinion. I'm gonna move on to this device. This is the Cyberpunk-themed OnePlus 8T, and I was gonna do a dedicated video on this thing last week, but I thought I'd wait to come get these things in and do this kind of compilation video for you guys. This is a really cool phone. So we're gonna start off with the packaging. You get it, it's a double package, right? You get the yellow box itself with the phone, and then the secondary package of pins. And I think most of these pins represent the various gangs of Night City, and you got that hand, like I think this is from the Keanu Reeves character, Johnny Silverhand, but these are all just kind of collector's items. And then you have the main package with the phone, and this was a really cool unboxing. This has a ton of attention to detail. There's that map, which I'm assuming is the map of Night City, and there are inserts in here, right? Normally OnePlus fills this thing up with a whole bunch of OnePlus pamphlets, but this is filled with Cyberpunk stuff. So underneath the yellow tearaway, you have this poem or song, and then you also have this black poster. I think this was the weapon that was from that trailer, like the teaser trailer that the girl was using. It's pretty cool. And underneath this package is another compartment, and inside there you have the case to the phone as well as another one of those pins. Now you also get the phone as well as the charging cable and the 65 watt warp charger. The charging cable is red. It should have been yellow, but because it's OnePlus, it's red. Okay, the phone itself. This is cased. I'm gonna pop it out and show you the uncased version. This is one of the most unique backs I've ever seen on a phone. So the very first time I saw this, like in a picture, I remember thinking they screwed up. Like OnePlus should have made it a yellow phone, right? Cyberpunk is yellow. Why is this a black gray phone? It should be entirely yellow. But then I got this thing in person and I was totally wrong. There is so much going on this back panel. So I'm gonna try to describe it. So the first thing you'll notice in terms of how this is different from a regular OnePlus 8T is that the camera hump, the camera module is bigger, and it's got this, like you can see the 2077 and the kind of barcode on the bottom, but this isn't just printed on the glass. It's etched underneath and it's got this weirdly bright holographic glow to it, even when there isn't a lot of light. I don't know how they're doing it, but it looks cool. But the material that's on the back plate is something I've never seen before. It almost looks like this granite material, like as if you took stone, cut it, and polished it, it would look something like this. It's not, right? There's no way this is a stone material, but it's got that rough texture to it. But at the same time, you know it can't possibly be stone because of just how they've colored it and everything. But then on the bottom third of it, it comes back to a seemingly regular glass with a kind of yellow accent trim, similar to the McLaren OnePlus phone from a few years ago, but it's not just simple black. If you tilt it in the right light, you can see that this shimmer, it's almost like these ghost images on the black material of this glass. It is a very complex backplate. Like, this looks so cool, and it still fits the Cyberpunk theme, which was really hard to do. Like, if you think about it, they could have just made this yellow, right? It's just like a bright Cyberpunk yellow phone. Anyone could have done that, and it would have been easy to do, and it would have looked pretty cool, somewhat limited, but this is on another level. This is like, the guys that made this, the guys that put the thought into like, how do you design the material so it looks techy without it being, you know, too over the top, and still have yellow accents with the black, and you know, this is so well done. The unfortunate thing, the extremely unfortunate thing, is that this is a China exclusive. I had to ask OnePlus to send this over. I gotta send this thing back. I put my SIM in it, it works, but it doesn't even have the Google Play Store. It uses like Hydrogen OS and you have to use non-regular software. But God, this is so cool. I love this phone. I wish I could use this. Maybe I could root this thing? Maybe? I'll speak to OnePlus. Okay, so the phone itself is a regular OnePlus 8T, right? It's got 12 gigs of RAM, 256 storage, but the software has been tweaked. It's running this custom skin on it that looks so cool, like so, so cool. It's got the yellow and blue. It's got this neon vibe to it, and the wallpaper on it has this like flickering glitch vibe to it. This is so well done. The theme, the menus, the wallpaper, and the sound effects. The case that comes with it seems to do a pretty good job protecting it while still retaining the whole limited edition vibe to the phone, which I think a lot of companies screw up on, right? They have these limited edition phones, these special edition phones, and they include these super ugly cases. This like accentuates the whole cyberpunkness to the phone. I think they did an awesome job on this. But that is the Cyberpunk loot lineup. This was really cool. I'm glad that companies are making this stuff, because if there was one game that deserved limited edition or special edition products, it's this one. Okay, hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thumbs if you liked it, subs if you loved it. See you guys next time.